So you bought a big container of miso and you've made your miso soup and your miso ramen. You're probably wondering, what else can I make with this? Well, today I'm going to show you how to make a super quick 5-minute sauce that's sweet, savory, and jam-packed full of umami. And it uses ingredients that you already have in your kitchen. When you see how easy it is to make this sauce, you're going to wonder why you didn't know about it sooner. Let me show you how easy this is to make.
To make our miso mixture, just add 3 tablespoons or 45 grams of water to a small bowl. Then add 1 tablespoon or 20 grams of miso paste and 2 tablespoons or 45 grams of jam, jelly, or preserves. I'm using fig preserves here because I'm cooking pork chops, but you can use anything you have on hand. Give all that a good mix until everything is incorporated and set aside. Then heat enough oil to coat the bottom of a small pan over medium heat and add 1/2 teaspoon or 3 grams of garlic and 1/2 teaspoon or 3 grams of ginger to the hot oil and stir until fragrant, about 30 seconds. Add the miso mixture and cook for 2 to 3 minutes or until slightly thickened. Turn off the heat. Add 2 tablespoons or 28 grams of butter and keep the pan moving until it's emulsified in the sauce. Then season with a squeeze of lemon juice. Now the sauce is ready to use as is, and this is the way I serve it 98% of the time. But if you're doing the fine dining thing and you want something a little more refined, you can pass the sauce through a fine mesh strainer like a chinois to get the garlic and ginger out. This will give you a smoother final product.
This sauce can be made with any fruit jam, jelly, or preserve. Today I had pork chops, so I used some fig preserves, but I like to glaze baked chicken with miso apricot sauce, and it works really well with mango or pineapple jam for any fish dish. It's really a perfect sauce for any grilled, sauteed, baked, or roasted meat. It's just a great way to get more value out of that container of miso that you have sitting at the back of your fridge. So tell me in the comments what kind of miso sauce you're planning to make. And if you enjoyed the video, please share, hit like, and subscribe to the channel. Thanks for watching.